What up, girl? You come to my channel often?
So, this is a separate series to the Filmmaker's Journey series, but sort of companion? Sister? Lover? Series? French best friend series? It's a series that goes along with it, in a way. I'm gonna use this series to show you projects I've worked on, things that I've done along the way to get where I am now. The reason I'm not just uploading these by themselves as projects is I want to differentiate what I worked on in the past to get here and things that I've made intentionally specifically for this channel. So, starting it off, if you watched Filmmaker's Journey Part 1, you saw the resume that I submitted to get into film school where I am now, but I also mentioned having to create other material that I had to send in. And so this is part of that. I had to create a portfolio of creative works that was around 15 minutes. So what I'm gonna do is introduce each one of these separately and post them. And then I will also, at the end of that, make another video where I show the entire presentation. So it'll be the same videos, but it'll have like the full presentation that I sent. Why? I don't know. It'd be fun to reminisce and look at these projects again, give me a place to host them. And if you just happen to have found this channel and you're someone who's trying to get into film school or film program, you can see how a complete thundering dumbass got into film school, and then you can go, okay, well, that was shitty. I can probably do better than that, and then you can do better than that, and then you can get into film school. All right, well, let's get started. Look at that. Look at that fucking mic shadow. Did I not learn anything in fucking DP class? I shouldn't have put the light there. I should have put the light over there or over here, or I should have used this other light I've got on my desk to, like, see, this is how you know this is gonna be a shit YouTube channel. I'm gonna be the worst YouTuber of them all. Okay, first video. This one is called... If you're following me from CaptainKenner95, you've already seen it, it was already there. I'll give you a little context here. This was a project I did with the main star of it, Todd P. Nelson, good friend of mine. We had thought about this project for a long time. It was one we were developing. We had this idea of just going inside the mind of somebody who is permanently handicapped in a way that they can't even speak, move, or really communicate to anyone else outside of like small head nods, eye blinks, hand twitches, and that's it. And sort of seeing what it's like having that perspective, not being able to communicate, and then sort of use that to show how people project their views of people onto them. And so everyone around this character sort of imagines him as suffering and miserable and, you know, depressed maybe. But every time we go inside his head and we hear what he thinks, he's actually more content and more satisfied with life than pretty much anyone around him. But he can't communicate that to anyone. And that was sort of the core idea for this. So this was a little piece we put together to explore that. And we actually spent a lot of time workshopping this, and we actually wanted to make a series of 4-5 episodes, sort of like progressively getting deeper into his way of thinking. So this was the first project that we made. We made it with no budget. We made it just camera I had. I had one or two lights. Didn't know anything about lighting properly. Had to use the microphone in the camera, so the audio was not good. Basically, this film had a lot of problems, but we were just really focused on trying to tell the story and get it done, and I was working under time constraints because I wanted to make new projects for everything I was going to send into the film school. So that's a whole bunch of hubble bubble do about this, but now that we got that out of the way, you can sit here and enjoy.
watch some TV while I'm making breakfast. Yeah. What about this? No? I think Shark Week's still on. You want to watch that? Okay.
She smells like that a lot. But I can tell it's been tiring to have me around. She tries not to show it, but I can tell how heavy her footfalls have become. The spring isn't there anymore. She'd only just made it through college and started to build her own life when the accident took our parents and left me in her care. I don't think it's been easy. She hasn't went out much since I was forced to move in. I know she's lonely. And I don't count. I mean, not really. I can hardly move my head or twitch my hand. That's not enough to give her the connection she deserves. All I can do is listen. And, well, for me, that's actually a lot. I'm happy just listening all day. Hearing all the conversation when she takes me out to eat or to the park. So many little stories happening all around, like a million little plays just for me. Most people probably think of me as trapped. A brain without a body. Well, not one to speak of, at least. I mean, I'm confined, certainly. But I don't know. It isn't really so bad. There's so much to learn if you're willing to listen. And I listen all the time. To the radio in the car, to the TV when people leave it on, and they always do. Sure. I don't get to choose what's on very often, but sometimes I feel like that's the problem. Everyone has so many choices to make. Sometimes I feel like because all I can do is listen and think, I've actually learned more than most people. Take cooking, for instance. My sister leaves cooking shows on all the time, but she doesn't really listen to them. She struggles. Every morning with the omelets. She can't ever seem to keep them from burning or falling apart. And she tosses them more often than she'd admit. She shouldn't add milk. And she should turn the heat down a bit. You need to take your time with omelets.
Get out in that kitchen and rattle those pots and pans. I'm a hungry man. I said, shake, rattle and roll. 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 Well, you never do nothing to save your doggone soul. Wearing those dresses, your head done up so nice.
Well, it's just a thought anyway.
So, there you go. That was my first short film that I made for FSU when I was applying. You can tell me what you think, whether you thought it was shitty, because it is. It's got a lot of shitty things. Or if you want to see what the other stories were going to be, you can leave a comment. Maybe we'll make the other ones. So yeah, next time, I'll show you the other two things I sent in, and then after that, we'll start getting into things I started making once I got to film school. So, yeah. See you next time.